Good afternoon, sir. Sir, please describe about your personal qualification and personal your experience, how you came here.
It's a long history.
Yeah.
If you want to go back. But briefly, I can describe. I did my undergraduate and postgraduate studies in Bangladesh. Then obtained a PhD from Australia. And professionally, I have been working as an academic. And then as a, what do you call this, administrator of higher education institutions and senior executive, both in developed and developing countries. I worked in Australia, Papua New Guinea, Fiji, Solomon Island, and as a visiting professor in other developed countries. And I was also an honorary advisor to the Commonwealth of Learning, which is based in Vancouver, promoting higher education, mainly open and distance learning, in Commonwealth countries. And with those experiences as an academic qualification at the same time, experience as an academic, as an executive of higher education institution, I returned home in 2012 as a foundation vice chancellor of the European University of Bangladesh. And after completing about 4 years service there, I joined as a vice chancellor of Hamdard University, Bangladesh.
Oh, it's great.
So that's a long story. Most one of the important achievement of my life is I was involved at the same time lead the establishment of 4 higher education institutions in Pacific countries. At the same time, as I told you, the foundation vice chancellor of a private university in Bangladesh.
Yeah.
And also helping the Commonwealth of Learning in establishing higher education institution for distance learning in countries like Africa and also Asia and other Commonwealth countries. So that's my background. And in terms of the research work, I have been doing research. My specialization background was economics. Then I added management at the same time, open and distance learning, and also mainly the teaching and learning approach in higher education. So one of my important area of interest is to conduct training program or workshop for the teachers, those who are teaching, on teaching and learning approaches.
Great.
To make them better teachers, better educators, better researchers.
Yeah.
So this brief I can tell you about.
So why Hamdard brought you?
I chose Hamdard University, Bangladesh, because what I wanted in my life, that I first believe what the philosophy of the Hamdard work fellowship is Bangladesh. In fact, the Hamdard University Bangladesh derived its philosophy from the Hamdard work fellowship is Bangladesh, which is serving the humanity through health services, through education, through spiritual development, through development of mental faculties, and person as a whole. That's the philosophy we follow in the Hamdard University Bangladesh, which we derived from the Hamdard Work Fellowship Bangladesh, our parent department. And then you can say that the Hamdard University Bangladesh is looking for the higher education, such a higher education that will produce the graduates or the postgraduates from the university, those who will be knowledgeable in their own subject areas. They will be well convergent about the research and arts for research, and at the same time they will also look for professional development and development of the human being.
Yes.
So it is not only just to make them professional, but also a professional who will take care of the humanity.
Yeah.
That's our main purpose. That's the reason in the university you can say that we try to create an environment conducive for producing that kind of graduates from the university.
To make a good soul.
And also, what I should say, to bring excellence in academia through promoting contract research, applied research, and all sort of research in the university. As you know, The excellence in academia is the interplay between the teaching and research.
Mm-hmm.
So we are emphasizing on research centers. That's why we have established laboratories, institutes in these institutions to promote the research also.
Yeah, I have find a very good.
That's one of the important areas for us. The second important area that in order to promote quality education, what is required first, I believe that you need a set of qualified and what you call the students friendly academia.
Mm-hmm.
And among them, you should have high profile professors who will profess their subjects, those who will lead not only the syllabus, curriculum, teaching and learning, the department and research, but also at the same time guide the staff within the department in order to become a better, what we call this, a quality academic staff in their life. So that's high profile professors we maintain in all the faculties and all the departments and universities. They're supported by mid-level academia, which is at associate professor level and assistant professor level. And we usually recruit them from the best universities in Bangladesh and abroad, and those who actually performed what you call this academically high level performance in their life. At the same time, they're very promising in terms of becoming a high profile academia in their life. And also, we also recruit what you call this, the best young academic staff in order to bring the young blood, young knowledge, and everything within the system at the same time to prepare a future army of academia for the year. So that's the way we try to bring a, what we call this, diverse quality academic staff within the department, within the faculties. At the same time, the second things we think that an environment that will have the teachers for teaching and students for learning. And that is the lab. If we have the engineering program, as you know, we have the Bachelor of Unani and Ayurvedic Medicine programs, and you will find that we have very highly qualitative laboratories in order to give them what you call this theoretical knowledge, at the same time practical knowledge, at the same time clinical knowledge and skills, so that they become the what you call high qualified practitioner in their life.
Yes, as there is a hospital, I find.
And then you will, you have seen that we have also a hospital that will help the students to learn their what they learn through theory, and then they do practice in the laboratory. At the same time, they practice as a practitioner, what you call this, as an intern in the hospitals. As you know that in the medical sciences, the students, they attend the theory classes, they do the practical at the same time. They go around along with their professors to see the patients practically. And what we call this, we sometimes try to use the problem-based learning. And that is, what they're learning theoretically, when they find a patient, they actually start a backward calculation. They try to identify the patient, what the issues, what's the problem, along with the patients, and from there they go back and try to find out, relate this with their theoretical knowledge and practical knowledge they have done.
Yeah, that's very
so we're trying to introduce a problem-based learning in order to make them such a practitioner that when they go in the field for practicing medicine, when they find a patient, they can easily relate their knowledge with these patients. So that kind of graduates we want to produce in our Bachelor of Medicine, Bachelor of Surgery, in their faculties. So, in also in engineering program, we do the same thing.
Yes.
They do the theoretical knowledge, they go to the laboratory works, and they go to do the practicing with different organizations in their professional areas.
Yeah,
say there are companies, there are institutions, they go and visit and do their internship. At the same time to time visit their companies in order to see what they're doing. And in that way, they're also having practical knowledge.
Oh,
become
great.
A real, what you call this, a knowledgeable person, at the same time a professional with high quality practical ideas and innovations.
Yeah, we trust the banner and I hope they will do quite better.
Yes, and another thing also I want to mention, which is very much appropriate for this, what you call this, globalization. And you know this, in the age of globalization, what is required, because every country is competing with each other. What is required that you should know how to manage the information, because there is no lack of information. At the same time, you should be innovative so that you can compete with other countries.
Mm-hmm.
Say if you want to do some business,
mm-hmm.
then you have to find a new way of doing things,
mm-hmm.
new product, new consumers in the market,
mm-hmm.
so that your product can create a new market or new consumers. That's the way we want our students not only to be a professional, not only to be an educated person, but also an entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
So that they don't go for law, don't look for job only.
Yeah.
They can go for establishing industries and business by themselves.
Yes.
Because that is the age coming towards. And then we also give emphasis the use of the, what you call this, information communication technology.
Yeah.
Because that's one of the areas that technically you have to make the students very high sounding,
mm-hmm.
so that they can compete with other countries, they can compete with other nations,
mm-hmm.
in order to develop their own areas and at the same time their own countries.
And you, sir, you also provide a scholarship to the abroad students. You will not feel any distinguishments or any
locals.
No,
what you call, that is one of the niche of this university.
Yeah.
What I mean, that's the way we separate ourselves from any other universities,
uh-huh.
in Bangladesh or even Southeast Asia.
Uh-huh.
The reason is Hamdard, as you know,
uh-huh.
is an organization. It is not making any profit.
Uh-huh.
It is a service organization.
Yeah.
And whatever surplus they are earning, they are reinvesting in education,
uh-huh.
and health services.
For their purpose.
And serving the humanity.
Yeah.
So that's the reason the university is not only running, we are charging very small fees to the uh-huh. students, but uh-huh. the remaining funds coming from the Hamdard uh-huh. Workforce Laboratories through its uh-huh. Hamdard Foundation.
Yeah, so
that's a huge amount.
Financially benefited.
Financially, actually, we are supported by them. In uh-huh. fact, we are subsidizing the students.
Uh-huh.
We are not charging the actual costs.
Good thing, sir.
So that's the way we don't differentiate Bangladeshi students or
Nepalese
abroad,
students. Yeah.
Because we are committed to the SAARC countries also.
Yeah.
So Nepal is a member of the SAARC countries.
Yeah.
Not only that, we feel like the Nepal and the Bangladesh is a very friendly country at this time.
Yeah.
Both diplomatically,
yes.
both what you call this person-to-person relationship, nation-to-nation relationship.
Yeah.
So that's the way we are always ready to help Nepal,
uh-huh.
the students if they are coming to this country,
uh-huh.
the facilities we are giving to the students in this country, we will give the same thing to the Nepalese students or any other students from other SAARC countries.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
So I hope my message is
of
very
course.
Sound.
Yeah.
And loud and clear.
Yes.
And my best wishes to Nepalese students.
Okay.
And I welcome them if they are coming to this part of the world. And if they can come, they will enjoy the education, the environment, the culture, which is very near.
Yeah.
So that's the reason my invitation.
So why Students Helpline is a very willingly associate with your university in the abroad market. And
so
we
my
open
invitation to the Nepalese students.
Yeah. So
to come and study.
Students Helpline will be the legend office in abroad in Kathmandu.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.